Talk about Shoebot. And Shoebot is a drawing program which allows you to draw using the Python language. So it's kind of like Logo. Some of you may have been taught that in school. I was taught that in school when I was like 10 years old. And Shoebot is this kind of program. There's some other programs today which are similar. Processing is one. And Shoebot is a very simple example of this kind of programming language program, which makes it ideal for teaching purposes. So the real kind of user base for this is teaching graphic designers programming. Why you would want to do that is an interesting question. And why you would want to do that is because a lot of graphic design tasks can be quite repetitive. And so if you know a little bit of programming, a little bit of scripting, then you become a much more powerful computer user. And if you're doing a kind of graphic design, like say typeface design, where you're making a font, then that can involve a lot of repetitious actions. You know, if your font has got 200 glyphs and you need to do something to every one of them, then writing a script to do that, rather than do it by hand 200 times, becomes quite enticing. And so Shoebot is a program which uses the Python syntax and all the kind of object-oriented ideas in Python, and it allows you to draw. So the website is tinkerhouse.net/Shoebot, and there's a very small development community. There's a mailing list, which you can see. And there's just a very small community there on that mailing list. It's a very small project. And the screenshots are probably a good thing to show next. So you can see here that you've got a small program which is creating this drawing. And you can see there that you've got some circles, some squares, and that you can have a program which kind of says uses random features, a random function to place them. So you can see here some of the functions which you can use, drawing paths, drawing shapes, it's a nice project to play with. We've got some animation features so that you can draw animations, and we're currently applying to have FFmpeg export so that you can export these as movies, and eventually we hope to use the Ming library to export these as Flash animations as well. And then we've obviously got SVG so that you can export the drawings that you create with Shoebot as SVG. And there's a plugin for Inkscape so that you can go to the plugins menu in Inkscape and specify a Shoebot script and it will run to create the SVG and then place that into the Inkscape canvas. So it's a very small little project, but I hope you guys might check it out and make some contributions. That's it. Questions? Yeah.
Does it choose any backend like
Cairo? Yeah, exactly. So it's a Python interface to Cairo, and it's got a command line. It runs on the command line, And then there's a GTK, there's a very basic IDE which uses GTK, and we're planning to write some configurations or plugins to popular text editors like Vim or Emacs or Gedit, so that you can write your ShoeBot scripts in whatever text editor you're comfortable with, and then have the image output on a separate window. So yeah, it's just a very simple Cairo wrap-up, really.
So you mentioned that one of the reasons that designers might want to learn about programming is that it makes them better, it makes them more capable, but it also gives them a certain understanding of what the programmatic needs of graphics are. So when they're working with a real graphics programmer, they also have a skill set where they can at least understand the mindset. Like when they're designing the graphics, they might make them with a different intention than if they had no idea about what programming is.
Yeah.
I find that when I work with designers on SVG projects, they sometimes make something that's completely unusable for me as a programmer. And I talk with them, and then once I explain to them, oh, I need to define that this thing becomes wider, they would suddenly say, oh, I need to draw this thing in a particular way so that it becomes useful as a graphic.
And I think the other thing is that you can, with these kind of programmatic drawing languages like Processing or ShoeBot or even Logo, as a kid, I mean, that the kind of drawings that you can make by programming a drawing is a different kinds of drawings to what you would draw visually. And so I think there's a lot of interesting potential for graphic designers to make generative graphic design using tools like this. And ShoeBot is really focused at that very first step, where a graphic designer who's never thought about learning to program can take, in a way which is got legs. Because the problem, I think, with things like Logo or Processing is that they are domain-specific languages for drawing, which means that if you learn them and then you want to start programming something else, well, you've suddenly got to learn a whole new language, a whole new syntax, and there's this kind of bump in the road. Whereas with ShoeBot, you're learning Python, and the Python that you learn to draw with ShoeBot is the same Python that you would use to do any other kind of programming, whether it's making a Django website or whatever. Yeah.
Is there anything built in to help with the Python syntax outside of these special commands? Because that's really, to be able to make something useful, you need to know that stuff.
These are kind of features which belong in an IDE. If you type rect open bracket, then you kind of get that tooltip that says, well, you need to put in an X and a Y and a width and a height and a roundness values. Is that kind of what you mean?
Loops. Various kinds of loops and conditional structures. Other kinds of conditional structures and other things that really would make a full Python script of some sort.
Yes.
Command by itself, the rect command.
Let me see if I can... Yeah, so this very simple program that draws flowers, you can see here that you've got a for loop that says, for I in range 10. I mean, that's a kind of simple Python programming construct, and this doesn't do anything to help teach that construct in itself. But by the fact that it's about making a drawing, then that makes that concept more accessible to designers, because it isn't this abstract thing about a for loop, it's saying, we're going to do this 10 times, we're going to place this petal 10 times, kind of thing. I'm not sure what the project could do really to help conveyors on servers. Yeah, I think we're out of time. All right.